how's been the journey actually? You're back again.
It's been a very tough journey for me, and it was a slow journey actually, because 3 years is a long time for any sportsman, and it is also during my prime time, I would say, and still it's okay. But I have learned so many lessons from these years of hard toil in the physio room, with the doctors, with the trainers, and with the bowling coaches. So it's been a great learning, I would say. And I've also come to figure out things, how to manage things and go across hurdles. Yes, it has been really helpful, I would say, in life.
Ashwin, before going into stress factor and all these things, what went through your mind when you first told that you have stress factor in 2017?
Firstly, I thought it was a major injury, definitely. But I didn't think it would be this much complicated at first. And then after getting into rehab and stuff, I also have so much experience with my groin injury. Like 7 or 8 years back, I've done rehab for 8 to 10 months in that. So I have this experience of doing rehab for a long time. So it was a normal process for me again to take rest for 2 months, complete rest, and then start my rehab and do my back-to-game stuff. But once I started playing, this confidence was not 100% for me while playing. That was one of the mind blocks which I had during the matches. And after 2 months of playing some intense cricket, I broke down again. So that was my initial thought in this process. And then after that, I came to learn about so many complications with myself, with my issue, what all complex things I have in my back. So after that, I started to learn about myself. That's where it started, this whole surgery process. Yeah.
Yes. So you played for Tamil Nadu the 2018 Vijay Hazare Trophy. And 4 months before that, when you first told that you have a stress fracture, I remember I did an interview of yours when it was the Times of India back then. You had said that in October 2017 that you had spoken a lot to El Balaji, who also recovered from stress fracture and made a comeback, stupendous comeback into the Indian team again. So you said that you had spoken to El Balaji on how to sit, various positions that you need to sit, walk, bowl, all these things. And then 3 months later, you made your comeback into Vijay Hazare. You all thought, okay, you had overcome from the stress fracture, but again, you broke down. And now it's been 2 years. So, we again talk to Balaji after you broke down. Whom all did you meet and explain that entire process?
Yes, firstly, when I had my fracture in 2017, I first went and spoke to Balanam because he was the most experienced guy with back injuries. So, I had a big conversation with him over call, over in person. I spoke to him lots about my back. And the thing about back injury is that it's actually unique to everyone. It's not the same with me and Balanna. It's different to everyone. What happens to me doesn't happen to another guy because there are so many complications in it, types of cracks and everything other. Mine is a bit more complicated. Balanna has had multiple fractures. Mine is not a multiple fracture, but it was accompanied with another slip vertebra. That was my issue. So, but the general advice which he gave me was very helpful, and still I'm following those things. It still works for me, but the treatment process cannot be managed by Balanna. He can only give you advices. So the physios and the doctors and trainers have to look after that. But my case was a bit more complicated because I told you I have a slipped vertebra, that is L5, which is a chronic thing. It didn't happen now. The L4 fracture was the thing which happened in the 2017 DNPL. After that, I gave my comeback after 7-8 months. And after 2 months, I broke down again. And from then till now, I've met almost 10 to 15 professionals in this medical field. Just professionals, I would say. I worked with Nitin Patel. You know, he's a physiotherapist of Indian team now. I was working with Rajini Kant. He was a trainer for me. And everyone thought it was a basic stress fracture thing, which could be solved in a couple of months, in a couple of months of rest and then a prolonged period of rehab. But it didn't turn out like that. Then after trying for 6 months and still I had the pain, I went to Mumbai to consult two or three spine specialists. I had gone to Mumbai earlier again with I was with Basu sir for a month or two. He told me to meet Dr. Aditya Daftari, and then he's a radiologist. He told me you fractured your back again. After that scene only I came to Nitin Patel. Nitin Patel sent me to Srikanth in Bangalore. Srikanth told me that your fracture hasn't recurred, so you will be fine in 2 or 3 months. So we started working for that, but still the pain didn't subside. So that's when I had many doubts. Many doubts, and I actually started doubting whether I'll be able to give a comeback or not. That was the phase, because the best physio in the country and the best trainer in the country are with me, and with the spine specialist telling me it's difficult for you to make a comeback as a fast bowler. I had developed so many self doubts. That was the thing, and then. From that phase, we decided to go for a surgery. Nitin Patel told me it's been 8 months of proper rehab, rest and everything, but we've not yet recovered. So let's go for a surgery. And we asked the opinion of the surgeon. His name is Vijay Ranawat. He's in Australia. He was the one who performed the... No, he was the one in the group who performed the surgery for Balana. So we had asked him, and then he also told me, yes, if it's 1.5-2 years of rehab and if still it's not getting okay for you, then we'll go for a surgery. And it was actually fixed with him. And then during that period, I tried all this Ayurvedic, all traditional medicines, everything I tried for a couple of months. After consulting with those Ayurvedic and Siddha doctors and trying all those medicines, it didn't actually work for me. And then once in Chennai, that is... In 2019, March, I would say, in March, I met Kasi sir somewhere in the Chepauk Stadium. He told me to go for another recommendation or to have another opinion from a surgeon, because I was already fixed with Vijay Ranawat and he was the only option. And first I said, no, I don't want any other suggestion or something, because I'm fed up with this rehab and everything. I just want to fix this surgery and then go for it. And also the second time I met him somewhere else, he asked me again. At that time, I was a bit I was a bit confused to whether just to go with Vijay Ranawat or get someone else's suggestion also. So Kali sir sent me to Tommy Simsek. He is a physiotherapist of CSK. And he gave me the contact of Dr. Rowan Scouten. He's a spine surgeon in Christchurch, New Zealand. And first I got his mail ID. I sent him a mail thinking I'll get a reply long, like after a month or after 2 weeks, I thought. But the next day after me sending the mail, I got a reply from him saying that, yes, I'll be happy to look forward in your case, something like that. And then I sent him my scans. And within 3-4 days, he gave me a detailed report, which no one has given me in the past 2 years. It was so clear and... it was actually so clear that I got to understand my case only then, exactly what has happened to my spine. That was the time I spoke to my parents, my trainers and physios, and convinced them I'm going for the surgery only under him, not under anyone else, because he was so clear and he's done so many surgeries before he's had so much experience with cricketers, right. Especially with fast bowlers like James Pattinson, Matt Henry, Amish Bennett. Shane Bourne was his senior. The one who performed surgery on Shane Bourne was Rowan Scouten's senior. Yeah. Rowan Scouten and his senior are all in the same group, I would say. And then in last year, June end, I went to Christchurch. And I got my back repaired. And after 20 days, we came back. And from then till now, it's been like... from then till the first match I played, it took almost 9 months with first 1.5 to 2 months of complete rest, and then start my rehab slowly, then my strength work, then my bowling work. Yes, it's been a long journey, long, very long journey. 3 years is a long time.
Hats off, Ashwin. Listening to you, no, don't have words to say, because it must have been pretty difficult, no, for you. A cricketer, you had played for India under 23 at that time when you broke down. There were a lot of dreams heading into the next season. So I can completely understand from your point of view. But you would have had received a lot of, you know, inputs, a lot of advice, a lot of people would have, you know, really wanted to help you and be with you. But how difficult was it to, you know, take some of those inputs, you know, and just assess, okay, is it going to work for me? Is it not going to work for me? That's a very difficult situation, right, to be in. And you have a lot of people who want to do something for you, but you are not sure whether it's going to work for your body or not.
Exactly. I'm actually grateful to many of my friends and colleagues and people around me, because they all tried to help me. No one was like, we'll just let him go. It's a major thing. We'll just let him go. Nothing like that. Everyone tried to help me in some way or the other, whether it's correct or not. They just gave their intentions by referring me to doctors, by sending me to new physios whom I've never heard of, and different types of treatments. But it was a battle for me inside, because choosing the right thing was the key. Still, I'd say there were mistakes in the process, like mistakes from my side and sometimes from the doctor's side because of bad diagnosis and all. So it really played with my mind. Some of my relatives told me, okay, it's a very hard battle. You just leave it off from here. You don't have a job now. Think of a job and then just leave it here. It's getting too complicated. Some relatives were like that, but friends weren't like that. Friends were supporting me, and my parents, I would say, were the biggest support, because seeing their son in the house not doing what he loves the most for 3 years was a big pain for them. And still, they supported me without asking me any question about my future or anything. They kept supporting. They just told me, you do whatever you feel is right for you. You just go with it. We are here to support you. And I'm so thankful for that, because not every player will get parents like that, sitting out for 3 years and still supporting them. Without, the main thing is, in Indian culture, like, we'll have to go for a job. Get a job. That is the primary thing in life for many. But it wasn't in my case. No one in my house, I didn't have any pressure. And I would like to thank Kasi sir, Palani sir, and TNCA for supporting me through these 3 years. Because as a player for Tamil Nadu and for India Cements, for the last 3 years, I have just played 3 to 4 games for my league team. And no one asked me a single question till now. I'm the same league team as before VJCC. And Kasi sir and Palani sir, whenever they saw me, they'll just say, you take your time, you do your work properly, and then you come back whenever it is good for you, or whenever you feel it's the right time. There's no hurry, there's no pressure from TNCA, there's no pressure from myself or Kasi sir, they were always behind me, supporting me. That was one great support. It was a source of confidence for me. My parents, TNCA, Kali sir, Palani sir, also Senthil sir from MRF Space Foundation, they kept backing me. Because 3 years out, no one will keep you in the same place. They'll just throw you out of if I'm in MRF Space Foundation, and if other players were there, they would have thrown you out. Because 3 years is a long time. But Senthil sir and everyone kept me there. Again, yes, I'm so grateful for that and thankful for that. But there were so many dilemmas within myself, so many battles I had to fight. That was because of few specialists, like doctors whom I met in Mumbai, told me not to continue bowling. They told me to start concentrating on my batting, so that I'll just have to do a little bit of bowling. But I was straightly into denial mode. I cannot do that. What I love the most is bowling. I cannot leave that and go to another department and do that. Because that's That's not what I play cricket for. So they were quite big spine surgeons in India. But still, I was in denial mode. I didn't want to believe them. That was the thing. And then surgeons told me it is not a 100% cure case. You might have complications in future, they told me. But still, this is the best chance for me. So I went for it. The first 1 or 2 years, I was very skeptical about things, about making decisions. But the last year, I was clear. It's been 2 years. Let me take the third year also and then just go for it. Because the thing I love and the thing I know in life is cricket, nothing else. So I'll just go all in for that. That was my mindset in the last year. Because the first 2 years, I was sulking. I was depressed and all kinds of stuff. But the last year, I was very clear and I was confident and positive about things. And yes, it has worked for me. After my surgery, I've been doing well. I've played one league match. And because of this crisis which is happening now, we're not able to play matches. I'm still keeping on my fitness. I'm going well. And there's no issue with my back as of now. Fingers crossed. Yeah.
So, Ashwin, every time when you stepped onto the field, not during your rehab, you would have bowled a few balls, like gently would have run in and bowled. Every time when you ran in at the first 3-4 days, what was going through your mind?
It was kind of a very satisfying feeling, I would say. Because last 2.5 years, I've been trying to bowl. And every time I bowl, I had this impingement or this pain in my back. Every time, every ball I bowled, I tried to bowl. And suddenly after this surgery, when I finished all my rehab and I started bowling, I felt so satisfied and happy. Those were the main feelings for me. I was happy because I'm able to do the thing which I love most again without pain. That was so satisfying and happy. And that feeling continued for almost 4 months because I started bowling in January till March end. Until I played those games, I had the same feeling. I was enjoying myself so much because I've lost so much of cricket in these times. So I started enjoying my bowling more. I was happy just to bowl, not picking wickets or bowling fast or just to bowl. I was happy, and I'm very grateful. I'm able to bowl like before, with the same pace and same kind of swing and everything which I had, without any niggle in my back. That is the thing which I have to thank Dr. Rohan Scouten for that. He was a great, he's a genius, I would say. Because he's done almost 11 surgeries on fast bowlers. And 11 were all only positive reviews till now. No one has had an issue till now with their backs. So he's doing a great job. I thank him for that.
You spoke to Dr. Rohan after you played that game. Did you call him up say, Dr. Einstein, I've played?
Yes. I kept talking to him every month about my progression. And even after playing the last game, the first game, I spoke to him telling me how I felt. I thanked him so much for that. Yes, I told him every detail I told him regarding the first spell, the second spell, the whole body, how it reacted to the spells. To the next right. day, how my body reacted, everything in detail. I spoke to him. Also, he introduced me to a physio from the New Zealand board, the cricket board. They have a physiotherapist. I spoke to his name is Dale Shackle. He is the one who's monitoring my rehab protocols from there. And he's coordinating with Satish Kumar, who's the physiotherapist of Tamil Nadu. And they're working together. In my case. I'll have to mention this because after my surgery and when we came back here, Satish sir had to go for the first class season with the Tamil Nadu team. So it was a battle just after the surgery, from the first rehab session till the bowling sessions, which I started in Jan. It was a one-man battle actually because my physio was not next to me. Training hadn't started yet. So it was me, myself, my parents, that's it. I'll do my rehab, everything on my own, at house or at the gym, at Pace Foundation, wherever. It was a lone battle, I would say.
Ashwin, now that you've overcome the pain, you're back again, you're bowling. So what's the message for people out there, for not sure whether it's a stress factor or not? How would you put it in your own style? Saying that, okay, if these are the symptoms that might lead to stress factor. Did you get something on those lines? Did you study a lot of things about that?
Yes, definitely. I've studied lots about back stress fractures and fast bowlers. Generally, stress fracture, like I said earlier, it's unique to everyone. It is not the same because there are so many vertebrae and so many types of stress fractures which can happen. Firstly, any stress fracture will give you a symptom earlier, which is the stress reaction. When you stop at the moment when you have a stress reaction, you'll be able to recover faster and then get back to game earlier, within like 2 months or 3 months max. But if you ignore the fact that you're having a stress reaction and keep playing those games with high intensity, you'll ultimately be fractured. That is the thing with stress fracture. You will get that reaction symptom earlier. In my case, I had this symptom. I didn't feel good about my back at that time. It was during the 2017 TNPL, after the second or third game, I'm not sure. I had this symptom. So I told my physiotherapist, I don't feel good about my back. I need an MRI done now. So straight away, after the practice session, I went for an MRI. And that MRI showed so many complications related and unrelated to my back issue. And it had shown a stress reaction. But at that time, no one could diagnose it. That was the biggest problem in my case. No one thought it was a stress reaction symptom. So after just 2 weeks of break and rehab, I played the next game, which was a league game in the TNPL. It was a league phase in TNPL. I just bowled one over in that, but I didn't feel good about it. And then next game was the qualifier. So it was a high intense game. So I had to give my everything. I bowled just 3 overs and I couldn't stand on the field. Yeah, it had fractured. My back had fractured. And it was a pain. It was the most painful feel I've ever had in me. And I just walked out of the ground informing the umpires. And that was my case. To youngsters who face back issues, I'd say, the first thing is to stop there and then diagnose it properly. Generally, stress fractures don't occur easily. It is a cumulative load which gives that stress fracture. So you've got to be really smart in managing your loads and the type of training you do, and it all affects your to overall fitness.
Yeah.
So that's what I'd like to tell to youngsters. And the main thing is, once you get that symptom, just stop it right there. Don't ignore it. And you should try and diagnose it. That is the main key. And then, again, well, like what I said, there's something called bowling load management, which I guess no one follows in India because of the number of games and the competitive nature in our domestic cricket and our local cricket. So we don't follow that. And young, like I'm saying, like under 15, under 14 guys don't have to think much about that. But once you cross that stage of playing, once you start playing state games and first division cricket in Chennai or somewhere in Mumbai like that, people have to start looking at their loads. And then the recovery is also very important. For me, I would say first is bowling. Second is recovery. Third is only training. But now, even I've done that mistake of doing more training and then bowling and then recovery. I'm not someone who's focused more on recovery. But that was the biggest mistake, I would say. And also, bowling is first. Bowling is priority. We are training to bowl, not bowling to train. That is the takeaway which I had in my issue. So you training is very important. Like just because everyone are lifting weights, everyone are doing these Olympic lifts which look very cool, it is not going to help you. Fitness industry is something which has developed only in the past 30, 40 years. I'd say like the traditional training we do now has come up in these years. And there is scope for so much to improve in the fitness industry. It is still evolving, and it is evolving I'd say the scope is very large. So we are still in the basics. What works for me will not work for another one. What works for him will not work for me. That is the thing in fitness. So you should be able to question everything. That is my opinion for youngsters. Just because every other, even if the best trainer, if the best physio tells you to do something, I'll tell you to question them. Why are we doing that? Is it transferable to our bowling, or is it transferable to our skill work? That is the question I had asked them. And that is the advice I'll give all youngsters.
Great, Ashwin. It was wonderful actually listening to you. So Ashwin, final question. Upcoming Ranji season. You're fit. You're back again bowling. What's your thought on that? How do you see it from here on?
My thoughts are simple. I just got to keep myself fit and then get back into the best version of myself. And regarding the Ranji thing, my first aim is Tamil Nadu should win Ranji Trophy. That is my first thought every time. If I play, if I don't play, if I'm not in the 11, if I'm not in the squad, my first thought is every time is Tamil Nadu should win every game, and it should win Ranji Trophy. That is my thought. And the second thing is, how can I contribute to that win? That will be my second thought. Even if I'm not playing, I should support the team in whatever way possible. And if I play, I should be able to win matches for a thing. And that is what I'm working towards now. Should have a strong mind, the best fit version of myself, and the best bowling version of myself. That is my aim for now, and that is what I'm working on currently. That is my short-term, like my goal for this year. And the ultimate goal is to play for India. That is the long-term goal.
Great, Ashwin. Thank you so much, Ashwin. We're all waiting for Ashwin Christ 2.0. It's the scene. Hope we see that during this first last season.
Thank you. Thank you so much.